As you may know from previous SAP Developer News episodes, the SAP BTP Innobytes is a monthly blog post and accompanying short video that you can consume in a coffee break and keep up with what's new on the SAP business technology platform. Last week, the February 2023 Innobytes edition was published. The blog post from Ceci covers the key theme, which this month is all about application development, with news on innovations in these areas: pipeline flexibility with SAP continuous integration and delivery, lifecycle management of multi-tenant apps using SAP automation pilot, and updates on a great harmonized approach to consume packages and services as data sources in SAP Business Application Studio. Check out all the details on Ceci's blog post and, of course, in the accompanying video. Talking of SAP BTP, did you notice recently that the SAP Help Portal URLs, the links for documentation, are now human-readable? Gone are those GUIDs, those globally unique identifiers, and we now have URL paths that we can read. The URL is an essential component in navigating the web, and using the URL to know where you are, what you're looking at, and where you've been before is a core part of a good and secure web browsing experience. Me, I love it. Thanks, SAP Help Portal team.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to SAP Developer News. Just a quick update. There's a new What's New viewer page for SAP UI5, including SAP Fiori elements, as well as a separate one for Open UI5. You can now filter for specific UI5 versions, as well as categories and the type of change that was done. Let's say, for example, you want to see all controls that were updated between versions 1.107 and 1.110. You can now do that. Check out the blog post by Oliver Müller in the description below for more information.
The latest release, 2302, is now available in the SAP BTP ABAP environment. This release brings significant improvements and new features to the ABAP environment, including enhanced support for ADT. Now, one of the most exciting new features of this release is the support for side effects in wrap behavior definition. This feature allows you to trigger reloads based on user input in draft-enabled UI services. Now, if you're interested in learning how to use side effects in wrap, check out Andre Fisher's blog post where he goes over how to configure side effects in the behavior definition of your wrap business object. Read Marv Jamal's blog post to learn more about the new features and improvements that comes with 2302. All of these links will be in the description below.